nonsense, you know my views. I've made them absolutely clear to you.
Might I ask, sir, how you came to hear this?
Never mind who told me. It's of no importance. I happen to know he was here this afternoon when you knew I would not be.
I won't let Jack Favell inside the gates. You can write and tell him for me to keep away.
If you want to see him, you can do so outside Manderley. Do you understand? I won't warn you about this again.
Oh, Maxim, do say yes. Don't be an old stick in the mud. It's a splendid idea. It's just what you need, my dear, to set you up properly as the new mistress of Manderley. The fancy dress ball always was the show of the year. Top dog.
Grand sight. Manderley all lit up. I love fireworks.
It does sound a little daunting.
Oh, you'll carry it off.
You wouldn't have to do anything alarming. Just receive the guests and dance the night away with all the Charlie Chaplins and Napoleons.
Yes, my God. Whole county making fools of themselves.
He always groans, and he always enjoys it in the end.
Do I?
That's a yes.
Yippee, old boy.
What will you wear, Maxim?
Oh, I never dress up. It's the one perk I insist on. What about you? Little Bo Peep?
Alice in Wonderland.
No, nothing like that.
What, then?
Wait and see. You might get the surprise of your life, Maxim.
Oh, Lord.
I'd like to help organize.
No. You leave all that to Frank and old Danvers. They know the form.
Quite right. Never volunteer, my dear. You just have fun.
Come and look, Clarice. Which do you like best?
Well, madam, they look beautiful.
I'm not sure.
Well, madam, it's so exciting. Mr. Frith says it'll be just like old times. You should hear my mother talking about it. She's thrilled to bits.
It has to be something really special.
Well, madam, it'll be wonderful.
Deciding what to wear at the ball, madam.
Nothing seems quite suitable, Mrs. Danvers.
I wonder you don't copy one of Manderley's own pictures in the gallery.
I hadn't thought of that.
It's not for me to suggest, but if you'll forgive me, madam, I remember how much you admired the portrait of the young lady all in white.
Yes, I do. Thank you, Mrs. Danvers. I should need a wig, of course, as well as the costume.
I know of some excellent shops in London that take care of all that sort of thing.
And it would have to be kept a secret, to surprise Mr. De Winter.
I think I know how to keep a secret, madam.
What the devil are you thinking about?
Nothing.
You look like a little criminal. What is it?
Nothing, really.
What goes on in the tortuous minds of women would baffle anyone. Don't like to think of you as a scheming kind of woman.
Perfect, madam. Fit for a queen, madam. So handsome.
Oh, yes, it is.
It is, Clarice. Oh, it is. Now the wig, Clarice. You ready? Beatrice? You can't come in.
Oh, I'm dying to see you. Do come on before the mob arrive.
Just another minute. Wait for me downstairs.
This had better be good.
Now the hat. Oh, madam, what will Mr. De Winter say?
Oh, yes. What will he say?
I can't imagine what's going on. She's been up there for hours.
Big occasion for her, old boy.
Anybody comes.
Change?
Yes, change. It doesn't matter what you put on, anything will do. But what are you standing there for? Didn't you hear what I said?
Of course I knew at once it was just a terrible mistake. You couldn't possibly have known. Why should you?
Known what?
About the dress. The picture you copied. It's exactly what Rebecca did for the last fancy dress ball. Identical. There you stood at the top of the stairs. And for one ghastly moment, I really thought... Well, it's over now. You poor dear, how were you to know?
I ought to have known.
Nonsense. It wasn't the sort of thing that could possibly occur to any of us. But it was such a shock, you see. And... Maxim...
Yes, Maxim?
Well, Maxim thinks, you see, that it was deliberate on your part. Because you did tell him you'd surprise him, didn't you? And for him, it was the most frightful shock you can imagine.
Yes. I should have known, I should have seen.
No, no. Look, don't worry. You'll be able to explain the whole thing to him quietly. Everything will be hunky-dory. We can tell everyone that the shop sent the wrong costume and that you're coming down in ordinary evening dress instead, hmm? Now, let's find you something nice.
Why not? Make anything up. What does it matter?
That's the way. For Maxim's sake.
And it's a sweet little frock, really.
Tonight, Josephine. Sorry, De Winter. Emperor's prerogative.
Better on a horse. Meet Colonel Julian.
Charmed, Mrs. Julian.
Doesn't look the pillar of rectitude one would expect for a district magistrate, does he? Come on, Charlie.
Come on, my dear.
Oh! done, Manderley.
Stop pretending. You don't love me, you love Rebecca. You've never forgotten about her. You think about her night and day. Rebecca, Rebecca, Rebecca.
No, you're wrong.
What does it matter that I love you? What kind of love is that to you? Like a child or a pet dog?
No.
You want something else I can't give you. What you had with her, you belong to Rebecca.
I have to...
No, don't touch me. I'm not Rebecca. But she's here, in this room. I can smell the scent she wears.
Please.
No! No.
Good morning, madam. We cleared away, but if you would like breakfast.
No, that's quite all right, Frith. It is late. Did Mr. De Winter have breakfast?
No, madam.
Is he in the library?
No, madam. I haven't seen Mr. De Winter this morning.
Morning, madam.
I'm afraid last night we made a lot of work for you.
As long as everyone enjoys themselves, that's what really matters, isn't it, madam?
Yes, of course. Have you seen Mr. De Winter yet?
No, madam, not yet. Not this morning.
Thank you.
Carry on. Is anything the matter?
I must find Maxim. Have you seen him?
Well, he hasn't been in the estate office. He's probably taken himself off for a long walk. Morning after, you know. It must have been very distressing for you.
He didn't come to bed last night, Frank. I said things to him. I didn't let him answer.
You're still tired. Get some more rest until he comes back. You mustn't blame yourself. You weren't to know about the dress. Look, I've got to get going. Don't worry too much about Maxim. He'll turn up when he's ready. It's his way.
You've done what you wanted, haven't you? Are you happy now, Mrs. Danvers? You made me wear that dress last night. You did it just to hurt Mr. De Winter, to make him suffer. Hasn't he suffered enough? Do you think his pain can bring Rebecca back again?
What do I care about his suffering? He's never cared about mine. How do you think I felt watching you take her place, walk in her footsteps, touch the things that were hers? What do you think that's meant to me all these months, hearing the servants calling you Mrs. De Winter? And all the while, my Mrs. De Winter, lying dead and forgotten in the church crypt. He deserves to suffer, marrying a chit of a girl like you not 10 months after. Well, he's paying for it, isn't he? He's made his own hell, and he's no one but himself to thank for it.
It isn't true. We were happy together.
On your honeymoon. He's a man, isn't he? Of course he enjoyed himself.
How dare you speak to me like that?
A bit of spirit, after all. Spirit. No one could match my lady for spirit. I looked after her ever since she was a child. She had men turning their heads to stare at her when she was 12 years old. She always knew she was going to be a beauty. They were a pair, her and her cousin, Mr. Jack. Did just whatever they liked together. Ah, she had the strength of a little lion. I remember her getting up on one of her father's horses. A real brute of an animal they said she'd never ride. I can see her now. Her hair flying out behind her. Slashing at him. Digging the spurs in. She rode him all right. She had him trembling all over, all froth and blood. That'll teach him, won't it, Danny, she said. And that's how she went at life. Till she died. She's dead. Oh, oh, she's dead.
You're ill, Mrs. Danvers. You should rest, see a doctor.
Leave me alone. What's it to you if I show my feelings? I'm not ashamed of them. I don't shut myself up in my room to cry like Mr. De Winter. Oh, yes. I used to hear him behind his locked door like a trapped animal.
You must stop this.
He was mad about her. Like every man who ever looked at her once. And he was so jealous. He still is. That's why he won't let Mr. Jack come here.
I won't listen.
It's no use, is it? You'll never get the better of her. Even if she's dead, she's still mistress here. She'll always be the real Mrs. De Winter. Why don't you leave Mandalay to her? He wants to be alone with her again. It's you that should be dead. Why don't you jump? It's easy. It wouldn't hurt. Jump. And have done with it. Then you won't be unhappy anymore. Go on. Don't be afraid. It's for the best.
What is it? What happened?
It's the rockets. There must be a ship down in the bay. When you see Mr. De Winter, madam, Tell him there'll be a hot meal ready for the men at any time.
Thank you, Frith. I hope you won't think me odd. I've been in a bit of a daze.
Would Madam perhaps like me to send for Clarice? Perhaps you'd like to lie down?
No, no. In a moment or two, I'll go down to the cove. Everyone else seems to be there.
Yes, indeed. Very good.
Is anyone hurt?
Nothing serious. She'll not go down too fast. Lifeboat's here at last. Got him?
Got him.
Maxim's always absolutely splendid about anything like this. Can't do enough.
I'm sure.
I'd better go and round up the troops. They seem to want to make a day of it. Shall you stay?
Yes.
She'll break up bit by bit. She'll not sink like a stone like the little one. The fishes have eaten her all up by now, haven't they?
What do you mean, Ben?
The other one. I looked in. She said she'd have me put in the asylum. She can't now, can she? The fishes have eaten her. They have, haven't they?
You've nothing to worry about, Ben. Sailors on the wreck.
Yes, no one's much hurt. The lifeboat's taking the rest of them down to the harbour for checkups.
Are you all right? You look tired.
I haven't slept. I just walked.
All night. Have you forgiven me for last night, for all I said?
Am I forgiven?
Let me start all over again. Be truthful with each other. Please, Maxim. I've grown up since last night. I'll never be a child again.
Won't you? What the devil's all this about? Look, he's my stretch of the coast. Some red tape or other. God knows what this is about. Look after things, will you, Frank?
Yes, of course. Never afford him. He'll be all right.
Only If I could have a quiet word with you, please, sir. I'm sorry about this. But this is rather a delicate matter, and it should remain really between us for the time being. The last thing I want to do is cause you both any pain or distress. It's hard on you that we can't just let the past lie quiet. But I don't see how we can under the circumstances. We sent a diver down, and he found something none of us expected. The little sailing boat that belonged to the late Mrs. De Winter. But that isn't all. There's a body in the cabin. No flesh on it, of course, the water seemed to that. I'm sorry, Mr. De Winter, but it's my duty to tell you. And report it further, officially, of course.
Yes, of course.
Becca was supposed to be alone. There was someone with her all the time, and no one knew.
So it appears, madam.
There was so much about it at the time, in the papers, and no one was reported missing.
Not now.
Questions to be asked and answered. There'll be publicity, I'm afraid. An inquest, of course.
Oh, excellent, I'm so sorry. Must you put my husband through this all over again?
I have to report that body.
It's too late. We've lost our chance of happiness.
No.
It's happened. The thing I always knew would happen. Always. Well, I remember that look in her eyes before she died. She knew this would happen. Rebecca knew she'd win in the end.
What are you telling me?
It's Rebecca's body they found in the boat. Look, the woman buried in the crypt is someone belonging nowhere, no name, unclaimed. No one, never was an accident. Rebecca didn't drown. I killed her. I killed her in the cottage. I carried her body to the boat and sank it. Can you tell me you love me now? No. I'm a fool even to ask it. Over. Everything.
Maxim, look at me. Look at me, Maxim. We can't lose each other. I love you, Maxim. What else is there?
I hated her. We never really loved each other. I don't think she was ever capable of love.
All those years. All the pretense.
When I married her, I was told I was the luckiest man in the world. Wasn't she so lovely, so accomplished, so amusing? I got the truth 5 days after we were married. You remember that day in the car up above Monte Carlo? You asked me if I'd been there before. She told me all about herself. The affairs she'd had, the sort of men. Plenty of detail. And she didn't intend to change.
Look. I'll make a bargain with you. Of course I'll look after your precious Manderley for you, Max. I'll make it the most famous showplace in the country. They'll say we are the happiest, luckiest, handsomest couple in all England. What a triumph. What a goddamn triumph we'll be, Max.
Oh, what a dreadful.
What a wonderful, marvellous joke. You'll go along with it, Max? Of course you will. Anything for the pride and honour of your good name and Manderley. Of course you will.
She was right. I did. I was a coward. I just couldn't face the humiliation. She was so clever. They all believed in her down here. Servants, friends, relations. None of them knew how she despised them all. She'd walk around some garden party arm in arm with me, smile on her face like an angel. The next day she'd go scurrying back up to London to that flat of hers like some animal to its hole in a ditch.
You don't have to tell me anymore.
Months, years, I accepted it because of Manderley. What she did in London didn't touch me because it didn't hurt Manderley, so I told myself. And then she started bringing her special friends down here. Midnight picnics at the cottage. Especially that cousin, Jack Favell. I couldn't allow that. Not here, not him. I told her I'd kill him if I found him anywhere at Manderley. And one night I came home late. She'd gone up to London that morning. I was surprised she'd come back already. Some of her things were in the hall. And I knew where she'd be. And he'd be there with her. I couldn't stand it any longer. All the lies, deceit. I had to make it stop. She could live in London with him, or any of the other men if she wanted to, but not here, not at Manderley. Go. It was over. Finished.
Well, you're wrong, Max. Put the gun away. He isn't here. No one's here. And it isn't over, Max. I'm not prepared to just go.
I'm divorcing you.
Haven't you thought how damned hard that would be? Think of us in a court of law. We have the model marriage, don't we, Max? Everyone knows that.
I'll get proof.
No, you won't. Not a chance. We've both played our parts too well. We're a loving couple. We adore each other. Not a servant here knows any different. Take Danny. Did anyone ever have a more personal maid? She'd swear anything for me in court. You wouldn't have a hope in hell.
I could kill you.
Suppose I had a child, Max. Who's going to prove it isn't yours? No one. It would give you the thrill of your life, wouldn't it, Max? To watch my son grow into his inheritance.
It won't happen.
God, it's so funny. All the smug locals and miserable peasants who bow and scrape to you. They'll be so pleased. What we've always hoped for, Mrs. De Winter, they'll all say. I'll be the perfect mother, Max. Just like I've been the perfect wife. And none of them will ever know.
Took the boat out into the bay and used a spike to drive holes in the bottom board. I left her there. I waited and watched till it was all over. Seemed like a lifetime.
Sank too close into the shore. I couldn't handle her well enough. If I could have got her right out beyond the reef, they'd never have found her.
It was the shipwreck. If that hadn't happened.
She was too close in. And finding you hasn't made any difference to it. Loving you hasn't altered things. She knew she'd destroy me in the end.
Rebecca is dead. She can't harm you anymore.
There's her body. They'll identify it. Her rings, maybe some of her clothes. It's not like a body lost at sea, battered against the rocks.
Well, if they find out it's Rebecca, you must say that the other body was a mistake. The body in the crypt was a mistake. When you identified it as her, you were distraught, ill. You didn't know what you were doing. It was a mistake. You will say that, won't you, Maxim?
Yes, yes, I will. I killed Rebecca. It's done. I don't have any remorse for that. What I regret is what I've done to you. See, it's gone. That funny, young, lost look you used to have that I loved so much. It's gone and it won't come back. I killed that too.
But we have each other. They can't prove anything against you. Nobody saw you that night. No one knows but you and I, Maxim. The only two people in the world. You must do this for us.
You say it was nothing unusual for your late wife to take her boat out at night entirely alone.
Not at all unusual. It was one of her great pleasures in life.
And she was an accomplished yachtswoman.
Very. She was accomplished at everything she did.
I was asking specifically about her ability in the handling of a sailing boat.
She was highly proficient.
Can it matter now? Stupid.
I would prefer no comment on the evidence given in my court.
Watch your step, girl.
Sailing calls for caution in the judgment of weather conditions, doesn't it?
Of course.
Would you describe the late Mrs. De Winter as reckless?
Certainly not.
But she did have a reputation for welcoming danger.
What do you mean?
As a sportswoman, Mr. De Winter.
Yes, I suppose that's true. She was not a timid person.
Say that again.
Manners be...
A strong-willed woman, Mr. De Winter.
It's fair to say she knew her own mind.
You are James Tabb, boat builder, and you say you carried out the work of converting the late Mrs. De Winter's sailing yacht from its original construction as a fishing boat of French design. Is that correct?
It is, sir.
Was the boat in a fit state to put to sea?
She was, when I fitted her out in April last year. It was Mrs. De Winter's fourth season with her.
Had the boat ever been known to capsize before?
No, sir. And I'd have soon heard of it from Mrs. De Winter if it had.
I suppose great care would be needed to handle this small vessel in rough weather.
Well, she wasn't a cranky little craft like some. She was stout and seaworthy. Mrs. De Winter had sailed her in much worse weather than there was that night.
So did it surprise you that the boat was lost that night?
I couldn't understand it. I've said so all along.
Well, she was lost. That's all there is to it.
But surely if Mrs. De Winter went below, probably for a coat, as is supposed, and a sudden gust of wind came down from the headland, that would be enough to capsize the boat.
No. No, not in my view.
Well, that seems to be what happened. No one's blaming your workmanship. I accept your statement that you delivered the boat in sound condition, which is all I wish to know from you. It seems Mrs. De Winter relaxed her watchfulness for a moment and lost her life. Such accidents have happened before in local waters.
Excuse me, sir. But there's a bit more to it than that.
Indeed. What precisely?
After the boat was brought up, I got permission from the harbour master to examine her. What I want to know is, who drove the holes in her planking?
What's the fellow telling us now?
Are you saying deliberately done?
I am, sir. I'm saying the boat never capsized at all. She was scuttled.
Does the man think he's sane?
Mr. De Winter, do you know anything about those holes driven in the planking?
Nothing whatever.
It is a shock to you, of course.
It was a shock to find that I made a mistake in identification some 12 months ago. Now I find that my late wife not only drowned in her cabin, but that the boat was damaged with deliberate intent that it should sink. Does it surprise you that I am shocked?
Mr. De Winter, we all feel deeply for you, but I have to inquire into this matter and will do so. I don't do it for my own amusement.
That's quite obvious.
Oh, Maxim, don't lose your temper.
Do we agree that whoever took the boat out that night must have driven the holes in the planking?
So it appears.
It appears very strange, does it not?
Certainly.
You have no suggestion to offer?
None at all.
Mr. De Winter, painful as it may be, it is my duty to ask you a very personal question.
Very well.
Were relations between you and the late Rebecca De Winter perfectly happy?
That's disgraceful.
Oh, look!
Will someone please help my wife?
We'll take her out.
All right, careful. Feeling better? Good girl.
Yes, I'm sorry. What a stupid thing to do. It was so hot in there.
And that stupid little man asking those ridiculous questions. What does he think he's doing?
Bloody silly business.
Where's Maxim?
He's still in there. They're probably going over all the evidence again. I'm going to take you home now.
No, I have to stay with him.
Maxim told me to take you home. Giles and Beatrice will hang on here. It's what Maxim wants.
And you better behave yourself in there, old girl. Coroner ticked her off.
Stupid little man. Fancy listening to that boat builder chap. How can he tell how those holes were made after all this time?
Bloody silly business.
Boat builder chap's probably a communist, making trouble. Just the sort of thing they do, you know.
Jack Favell, why was he there?
Rebecca was his cousin.
Why was he there with Mrs. Danvers?
He's known her since he was a boy.
I know that, Frank, but what does he want now? Is he going to tell them something? Something against Maxim?
Can't think what.
Favell and Mrs. Danvers. So mixed up with Rebecca, her other life. Frightens me.
You need to lie down. All this has upset you.
You must know as much as anybody, Frank. Tell me what you think's going to happen.
As long as Maxim keeps his temper and doesn't let the coroner rile him into saying things he doesn't mean, why shouldn't it end up just like it was before? It always was a bit of a puzzle. She was alone in the boat and she drowned. Strange accident.
And that's all you know.
Lie down, won't you?
I ought to be there with him. He will come home today, won't he?
Please, go and rest.
I killed her. I'm glad I killed her.
The jury brought in suicide without sufficient evidence to show state of mind.
Finished?
Not quite. Frank and I have to go to the church to bury her. Just the two of us and the vicar. And then it's over. Go in. I have to go.
Please show him in for us.
Very good, madam.
Good of you to let me in out of the rain. Didn't think old Max would be back yet. Last rites and all that. I just brought old Danny back. She's feeling a bit knocked sideways by it all.
What do you want?
Well, at this precise moment, I could use a large whiskey and soda. Mind if I help myself?
Why do you want to see Maxim?
Oh, you'd have been proud of old Max if he'd stayed. Terrific show he put up. Stonewalled him all the way. Such dignity. Never raised his voice. Made that little ferret of a coroner look a real gutter snipe with his prying questions.
What questions?
Oh, nothing damaging. Although he would keep fishing. Did Rebecca have any money troubles, for one thing? Money troubles, for God's sake. Old Rebecca must be laughing her knickers off.
Wouldn't it be better if you called at the estate office in the morning, if you need to see Maxim?
Oh, now don't chase me away. You think I'm the big bad wolf, don't you? But I'm not, really. I'm just a perfectly ordinary, harmless bloke. And I think you're behaving splendidly over all this. Taking on this great place. Meeting all these people you've never seen the like of before. Putting up with old Max and his moods. And then finding out the truth of it all. Because you do know the truth, don't you? Just like I do. That's why you fainted at the inquest, isn't it?
I don't understand you. I think you should leave.
I'm going to see justice is done to Rebecca. Suicide, my God. Where did they pick that jury from? The local loony bin. Out of this house, Favell, you've been told before. Hold on, Max. I'm here to congratulate you on the inquest. Raise a glass to your nerve. Oh, do you mind if I...
Do you want to be thrown out?
Yes, you better listen to me, Max. I can make things very unpleasant for you. Dangerous, in fact.
Tell me how.
Well, now, look, Max. Let's come clean about all this. I don't suppose there are any secrets between you and your wife. And from the look of things, Crawley here makes up a happy trio.
Would you like to leave us alone?
No, I'd rather stay. Really, Maxim.
So, I'll speak plainly. You all know about Rebecca and me. We were lovers. I've never denied it. Never will. When she drowned, it hit me hard. Bloody hard. But it seemed it was just an accident, just lousy bad luck. Until today. Now we know better. Nothing to do with luck, was it, Max?
Suicide. Legal verdicts.
Except that I have other evidence. This is the last letter Rebecca ever wrote to me. It has a date and time on it. The afternoon before she died. Listen. I tried to ring you from the flat, but could get no answer. I'm going down to Manders right away. I should be at the cottage this evening, and if you get this in time, will you follow me down to the car? I'll spend the night at the cottage and leave the door open for you. I've got something to tell you, and I want to see you as soon as possible. Rebecca. I want to see you as soon as possible. Is that the sort of note you write when you're about to commit suicide? I've got something to tell you. And then you drown yourself. Trouble was, I've been to a hell of a party that night. Didn't see the letter till the next morning. By the time I got round to phoning here, old Danny gave me the news. Didn't help the hangover much. If I'd read this letter out to the coroner today, that would have made things a bit tricky for you, wouldn't it, Max?
Why didn't you?
Well, for one thing, old Danny doesn't know about it yet. And I don't think we want her to, do we? I mean, if old Danny were to find out that someone else had smashed those holes in the boat, that someone had murdered her beloved Rebecca, and it was you, Max, in a jealous rage, which is what I'd certainly tell her, well, I'd say that'd send old Danny right off her rocker. And God knows what she might be capable of. you and yours wouldn't be safe, Max. Even if you were to get away with it in court, which I doubt anyway.
Maxim?
You're just guessing. You have no proof.
Good old loyal Frank. Always ready to suck up to your lord and master.
Stop that, Favell. What is it you want?
Oh, look, I don't want to smash you, Max. God knows you've never been a friend to me, but I don't bear any malice about that. All married men with lovely wives are jealous, aren't they? And some of them just can't help playing Othello. I don't blame them. I'm sorry for them. I can't think why fellows can't share their wives instead of killing them. What's the difference? You still get your fun. A lovely woman isn't like a motor tire. She doesn't wear out. The more you use her, better she goes.
For God's sake, man.
You snotty little prig. You tried your luck with Rebecca and didn't get very far, did you? Do you think it'll be a bit easier with the new bride? An arm every time she faints and she'll be so grateful, won't she?
Maxim, no!
Leave it. You asked for that. Did I? I want some money out of this, Max.
For what?
Keeping quiet.
Not a penny.
What do you have in mind, Favell?
2 or 3,000 a year for life. You can afford it. Cheap enough to save your neck.
Blackmail? Never.
Insurance? Best you ever had.
Frank, get him cleaned up and get him out.
Come on.
Max, it's all gone too far. Rebecca's note, the way you said about me, the jealous rage, just the way you had to kill Rebecca. If I go to the police, they'll have to put you on the spot.
No one's going to arrest me for giving you a bloody nose. It's an occupational hazard in your kind of life, isn't it?
Max, old boy. See sense. Make me an offer. Or else.
While you're washing your face, Favell, I'm going to call Colonel Julian. He's the district magistrate. When he gets here, you can tell him your story and see what he thinks about blackmail.
You wouldn't dare.
Frank, get him to the bathroom, please. Colonel Julian can be here in half an hour.
Right, Max. You're putting a noose around your neck.
Come on, man, you're drunk.
You and your bride think about that. You had your chance.
He knows. He knows.
I'm calling his bluff.
Well, he only wants money. You have money. You could send him away.
No, he'd always be there. We'd be his prisoners like I was Rebecca's.
I'm so frightened, Maxim. I know something dreadful will happen if we don't stop him.
It's the only way. Face him down till he's got nothing left. And then we're finished with him. And finished with Rebecca. Remember, he's only guessing. He knows nothing.
Oh, Maxim.
I'm gonna call Julian.
Why haven't you spoken up about this before?
Because he hoped I would pay him not to. Preposterous. He's playing a confidence trick, that's all.
And he's a murderer. And he'll pay for that.
Gentlemen, I am here because of serious accusations made by both of you, not in order to witness a brawl. As for this letter, it isn't evidence of anything criminal.
Precisely.
There's more. What's behind it?
Rebecca wasn't a wife to you. Admit it. When was the last time she let you touch her? She was going to ditch you and marry me. And you could see it coming, couldn't you, Max? The shame of it, the public degradation. Too much for Maxim de Winter. So you killed her.
Utter make-believe.
Who's going to say all this in court, apart from you?
Call in the police. I'm ready.
Well, I hardly think you are, just yet.
Give it up, Favell.
You don't have a single witness.
Oh, don't I? You could be wrong. There is someone. He was always creeping about the woods and the bay. And the cottage. He saw plenty he shouldn't have seen. We had to scare him off.
We never said nothing, did I?
Shall we have the sweet-smelling Ben along to tell us what he saw when he was playing Peeping Tom?
No, don't. I mean, it isn't fair on someone like that.
Max?
Frank, would you be good enough to get Ben along here, please? Shouldn't take long.
Yes, of course.
To Manderley. Hey, Max?
You did it all for this pile of stones and a few serfs tugging their forelocks.
Can I get anybody a drink?
Don't worry, Ben. There's nothing wrong. No one is going to hurt you.
Hello, Ben. How's life been treating you since I saw you last?
You know who I am, don't you?
Hey.
Go on. Take one. As many as you like.
It's all right, Ben.
Now, you know me, don't you? You've seen me at the cottage on the beach, haven't you?
Never seen you.
Don't be a bloody fool. You saw me at the cottage with Mrs. De Winter.
Never seen you.
Will this make you remember?
Has he come to take me to the asylum?
Answer me. You saw me with Mrs. De Winter more than once.
She's gone.
You saw us in the woods and at the cottage.
Never seen you.
Don't be frightened, Ben.
I don't want to go to the asylum. I want to stay home.
Pavel! Oh, yes. He's Manderley property. He says whatever you tell him. My God, he'd tell the truth if I put a stick across his back. All right, Frank.
I don't want to stay here. I want to go home.
Find him something nice to eat, Robert. And then take him home. Off with you, Ben. Nothing's wrong. Don't hurry him, Robert.
Yes, sir.
Get out, Favell.
Not finished yet. Get Danny in here. Let's tell her who killed Rebecca.
Frank, do as he wishes.
How did you do it, Max? You didn't beat her brains in. No sign of violent injury. Could you smother her? Strangle her? Drown her?
Don't overreach yourself, Favell.
Mrs. Danvers, please come in. Mr. Favell has something he wishes to ask you.
Right, Danny, tell these people about Rebecca and me.
Tell them what?
You know damn well. We lived together on and off for years, didn't we? She was in love with me. Just tell them.
No. She wasn't. She wasn't in love with you. Or Mr. De Winter. Or any man. She despised men. She was above all that.
You old fool. Didn't she meet me night after night at the cottage? Didn't we spend the weekends together in London?
What if she did? She had a right to amuse herself, hadn't she? Love. With you. With any of you. It was a game to her. She told me so. Make love with you. Or any man. She did it because it made her laugh. I've known her come back and sit upstairs in her bed and shake with laughter at the lot of you. You were her favorite, but it was always a game. I was the only one she really loved. Oh, they say the drowning is painless, isn't it?
There's your witness, Favell.
There's still Rebecca's letter. It was no suicide note. She was going to tell me something. What, for God's sake? If we knew that, it might explain everything.
Well, you'll never know now.
It might just tell us what it was made you snap at last, eh, Max?
You're finished. You're clutching at straws.
I didn't know she was in London that day. What was she doing? Who did she see?
Pointless. Forget it.
No, Frank. Let him chase his own tail if he wants to. It's something dogs do.
I'm gonna nail you, Max. One way or another.
No, you're not, Favell. Not without evidence. And we don't know where she went that day.
I have her private engagement diary. I kept all those things. Mr. De Winter never asked for them. There's an address book, too. I do want to see them.
Thank you, Danny.
De Winter, do you mind if we see this diary?
Oh, shall we go and get it?
I think I should do that. Mrs. De Winter, will you come with us?
Of course.
Now, where will this lead us, Max?
Yes. If you would, please. It is rather important. But that would be splendid. Yes.
She went to her hairdresser, then to her club for lunch, yes, and then to see someone called Baker.
Yeah, I've got it. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Baker's a medical man, clinical consultant, women's specialist. He'll see us tomorrow afternoon.
You know what he's going to say, don't you, Max? Now it all fits together. Now we know what sent you over the edge that night. Rebecca was pregnant with my child. She told you, didn't she? Just as she'd have told me if I got down here. That drove you to frenzy, and you had to kill her.
Stop it! Stop it!
How low can you stoop, Favell? You're finished, Max. I'm going to hang you.
Him.
woman who consulted me, giving her name as Mrs. Rebecca Danvers, was very ill. Very seriously ill. Clearly, she gave me a false name because she wanted confidentiality. And you know, our profession has to respect that, like the confessional. But from your description, this was your wife, Mr. De Winter. And she's now dead. The circumstances are exceptional.
Just get on with it, can't you?
There were two consultations. The second was to tell her the results of the examination and x-rays from the first, and their implications. She told me very forcefully that she wanted the plain, simple truth. No hints or evasions.
Yes, yes.
So that was what I gave her. She had no more than a few months to live. The cancer had taken too firm a hold. An operation would have been quite useless. Outwardly, she appeared to be a completely healthy woman. But the pain would increase from week to week, and she would have to be kept under morphia until the end came. She said she'd been suspecting it for some time.
Oh, Christ.
There is one other thing I think you ought to know, Mr. De Winter. The x-rays showed a certain malformation of the uterus, which meant she would never have been able to have a child. But that was a quite separate condition, nothing to do with the cancer.
Thank you for your assistance, Dr. Becker.
God, Rebecca. Tell that bloody fellow with the barrel organ to clear out. I can't stand his blasted row.
Can he drive his car?
Just give me a minute. I'll be all right. This has been a damned unholy shock to me. Cancer. Who'd have thought? A woman like that.
Oh, pull yourself together, man, for heaven's sake.
Turned out well for you, eh, Max? Your lucky day. You've got your motive for suicide. Except I still don't believe it.
He'll have to now.
Not me.
Then you'll keep it to yourself. The law is most severe on slanderous accusations. You two need to be alone. I'll take Favell to his flat and catch the night train back. Get in, Favell. This should be the end of the matter, but you know how stories spread in country districts. Give people half a chance. You may feel like getting... You know the old saying? Out of sight, out of mind. Just a thought.
Thank you.
Fare you well.
She lied to me about the baby because she wanted me to kill her. Her last practical joke. The biggest of them all.
She can't hurt us anymore.
No.
Do you think Colonel Julian could have suspected?
Quite possibly.
And Frank guessed some time ago, didn't he?
Oh, I think so.
But he'd never say anything.
It's over. We've got to begin again.
Where will we go?
Christ.
What time is it? The sky is so red. Is it dawn already?
It's not dawn, it's Manderley.
Anyone hurt?
Nobody hurts.
No one's seen Mrs. Danvers.
Maxim, don't!
She may still be alive.
Maybe she doesn't want to live. Maxim! Maxim!
Last night, I dreamt I went to Manderley again. The house was a tomb. Our fear and suffering lay buried in the ruins. There would be no resurrection. But I knew that when I woke, I would not be bitter. I would think of Manderley as it might have been if we could have lived there without fear. I would remember the rose garden in summer, tea under the chestnut tree, the murmur of the sea from the lawns below. These things will always be with me. They are memories that cannot hurt and sweeten this exile that we have brought upon ourselves. But I will not tell Maxim about my dream. We never talk of Manderley. And of course, we can never go back. Our little hotel is dull. And day after day dawns very much the same. Yet we would not have it otherwise. We are both free, although not unscathed, of course. There will never be children. But we are together, with no barriers between us. He is wonderfully patient and never complains, not even when he remembers. Which happens, I think, more often than he likes me to know.
Thank you.